Hi everyone. So let's start write authorizer lambda in this video. So we have already talked about this thing, that in this video we are creating this basic authorizer which can call to other service and decide, okay, we need to allow and deny this particular request. Okay, so what is the objective of this? So here, let's say you are making a call to an API to validate the token in authorization header, right? So here you are getting from the event, what you will get is you will get authorization header, and then you will just validate this. So we can call one particular service which is just going to get the token, okay? And then we are going to call this authenticate method, okay? So this is index.ts, we already have authenticate method, and this is async await. So what we can do is await authenticate, right? Authenticate, okay, it requires the event object. Okay, now what we are going to do in this authenticate, you can write your logic. I will not explain what you need to do. What you need to do is you can just go and get the token in the headers. This is just authorization header, and then you will call your service, just Axios post, and you will get the response from that. Okay. First, you extract out the token from the header, then make a call just to check whatever the token you have, the token is valid or not, right? Now, if everything is fine, right? You are able to execute this lambda and you are able to authenticate your request, then what you need to do? You have to generate the policy, okay? So here we have to write some code like a function generate policy. Because our policy will decide that what we are going to do. So policy will take three arguments, principal ID and effect, which is allow or deny, and method ARN. And here we will return the document. So we can create a policy doc. We can have one more method, generate. Policy document, and you will be passing effect and method ARN. Okay, and what we need to return from this is policy doc. So we will return policy principal ID from this and the policy document. Can say simple policy doc. This is the JSON object we are returning, and we have to write this method, which is function generate. Why this autofill is not working? Okay, here you are getting effect and method ARN. Let me just correct it. So we are generating policy document, and we are passing effect and policy doc. Sorry, method ARN here. Now what we need to do is if both are not null, right? If we are getting effect and or we are getting this method ARN. I mean, this is the condition if one of them is null, right? Then just return null. Otherwise, we have to create a policy doc object. And I mean, this is how we create a policy in AWS. Like, we just specify version and statement. Version is like 2012, 10, 17, okay? And then we will also add a statement. And statement will be a JSON object. It's an array of objects. So this action is important, because you are allowing to execute this action, which is execute API invoke. Okay, and you'll be passing effect. Whatever you are getting from the argument, you'll be passing the same, and resource. is the method ARN, because you are allowing to execute this against this method ARN. And finally, you return the policy doc. Okay, that's it, we are done. So we are generating the policy and all. So here, everything depends on this. If this token is valid, what you need to do is everything is fine. What you will do is you will just return this policy doc, generate policy, and you'll be passing all these arguments, event.principalID and all these things. So we get the method ARN, okay? So all these properties we will be passing from here. So you see what we are doing here is in the authorizer, right? So in the authorizer, we are trying to execute it. We are trying to authenticate. If everything is fine, we'll just generate the policy. And here we are passing the principal ID, effect, and ARN. So here, principal ID, effect is allow, and method ARN we already have, right? So here we have principal ID, so event.principal ID. So we'll get all these things from there. And then effect is allow. Okay, and method ARN we already have. This we have to return. If by any chance we are getting an error, right? So what we will do is deny. We just need to do this and we have to return it. Consider like in authenticate, if token is not valid, you are just rejecting the promise. So it will go into the catch block, error in lambda execution, or the token is invalid. Something you can log and you can generate the policy and return it. Something like this, right? So this is how we are going to write the authorizer. Now you just need to execute this authorizer. It is giving us everything. Okay. So this is pretty much we have in this video. Let's have a look on to our diagram. So this is how we are doing it. So now after authorizer, lambda has validated the request, right? Now we would be able to call the lambda properly, right? And lambda will execute whatever is expected from the lambda. Lambda will execute and it will give us the final response to us. Okay. So finally, our lambda will look something like this. So principal ID is user here, method ARN allow and deny. Okay, so we are just to authenticate. Authenticate is doing nothing but getting the token, extracting the token and validating it. And then we are executing this policy. The action should be fixed, execute API invoke. And the effect is either allow or deny. And method ARN, every lambda has its own method ARN that will be passed. Okay, so in the next video, we'll talk about this serverless framework. We can just start talking about it from this video. I will just talk about serverless. Okay, it's actually a framework which is now popular to deploy the applications. Okay. So this we can use when we are actually looking for some consistent way of deploying the lambdas, creating the whole process. Either you can React, you can build React App, Express, Full Stack, GraphQL, anything. So we will talk about just deploying a simple applications and all, and also talking about the offline execution of the lambda. So here also we have written this offline. What you can do is if you want to test this particular lambda, then you can invoke this offline. So what you need to do is we have to execute first this serverless and SLS. Okay. So first of all, let's first talk about serverless. Here I have shown you only the lambda code, not and haven't discussed anything about what to do with the serverless, right? It is just a simple handler in the lambda and doing executing some code based on the condition and giving you some policy, right? So let's talk about this serverless thing in the next video in the detail.